Hey, boss, got a couple of minutes?
Hey.
Guess who's on his way in?
What, Davidoff?
He just called the office. Arrange him a lunch, he says. He treats the office staff like his personal assistants.
He shouldn't be a drain on our resources. Look, I'll talk to him.
Can you let the garage staff know he'll be wandering around down there and make sure we have the usual room set up for him?
Yeah, no problem.
Roll out the red carpet. Davidoff's in town. Last I heard, he was joining us in Singapore, but today he just shows up.
Don't let him get to you like this. We'll handle him.
Remind me why I went into business with him.
At least you have an F1 team.
For now.
Look, he wants us to succeed.
Doesn't always feel like it, Cass. I'll see you in the meeting.
Yeah. Kelly.
People are saying Dad's heading in.
He is, yeah.
I thought he wasn't around this weekend.
Well, so did we. Listen, I heard what happened in the garage.
Oh, yeah. Look, please don't worry about that. It got a bit heated, but it's fine.
I can't have that behavior on the team. I'm giving the guy a warning.
Oh, is that necessary?
But it's not okay to talk about your own drivers like that.
Right. Well, you're the boss.
Yeah. See you in the meeting.
See you there.
Could you take a look at this, please?
Everything else looks fine. It's just about that rear wing.
I don't want to sacrifice any more downforce.
It's okay, it's your call. Now, let's check the weather again in an hour.
Oi, oi! Did you miss me? Hello, sis.
Hi, bro.
Jackson.
Devon.
How are you, Devon?
I am excited. Very excited to be involved again. Now, you pretend I'm not here. You carry on, please.
Involved? How?
Oh, you know, just a little bit of this, a little bit of...
Involved? How?
We'll figure it out.
And what does Andreo say to that?
He'll agree, Casper. It's fine.
Were they pleased to see you?
People are always pleased to see me.
And what was your new role?
I guess you might call me a liaison. Yeah, I love to liaise. Dad wanted me to talk to people, keep people's spirits up, give some friendly words of advice, that kind of thing. But it was tough. Yeah, Aiden still had that ego. Still thought he was too good for the team. Wouldn't listen to Casper's advice, that was a problem. And then Andreo... He was worried about the future of the team. He had Dad breathing down his neck. And Callie, well, Let's just say Callie wasn't really looking for my advice. The whole thing was a mess. I mean, honestly, I'd only been gone 5 minutes.
Connorsport teammates not exactly doing each other any favours this afternoon. For me, they're a little bit too close for comfort.
What is Aidan playing at? Tell him to back off.
Okay, Callie, he knows.
Clearly he doesn't know.
Yeah, same old stuff. Jackson really wants to make a move out there, but Mayer, no chance. Not letting him past.
Towards the curve of Grande we go. He's going for it. It's really close. It's too close. There goes Mayer. Front wing. Oh, Aidan Jackson, what happened there? This now seems like a running theme at Connorsport.
Yes, this race is critical for them. When are they going to just pull themselves together?
Okay, box please, Callie. Let's get that wing replaced.
This is a joke.
Box this lap, please. Box this lap.
Yeah, copy.
us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Teammates.
So Mayer managed to pull it back in the end. But if this continues, Connor Sport are in real danger of sabotaging their own chances of a decent finish this season.
There is so much talent in that team, and yet they're their own worst enemy. The reason they're not making progress is each other. Ridiculous state of affairs.
And it's clear that Jackson continues to be the aggressor. Is it personal, Natalie?
Well, you know, it does seem that way from the outside looking in, but all I know is they just can't go on like this.
Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today.
Now, once again, another eventful race out there today for Connor Sport, Kelly. Is the team sabotaging its own chance of a decent finish this season?
Punditry is your job, Natalie. No, I am not here to comment on those kind of narratives. I will stick to driving the car, thank you.
Everyone is talking about Devon's return to Connor Sport today, so is it good to have him back around again?
I mean, never tell him I said this, but I don't mind having him around. He's the most infuriating person I've ever met, but he knows the sport as well as anyone, and it'll be good to have his input.
Tell us, if you can, about this rumour circulating about a rift between you and your father, Davidov.
There's a lot of big personalities at Connor Sport, and there are going to be differences of opinion. That's the case in every team, right? I have really strong views, and so does my father, but we both ultimately want Connor Sport to succeed.
Now, in the past, you've refused to acknowledge the role of your father in getting your current seat at Connor Sport. Why is that?
What I said was I'm here because I deserve to be. I'm here because I can drive. I stand by that.
Thank you so much for your time.
Then let's have it.
That's no way to answer the phone.
Say your piece, mother dearest.
Fine, if you want to be like that. I did say you need to be careful what you tell the media about your father, didn't I? That was the perfect opportunity today to smooth it all over, but no, you only reinforced what everyone's already saying about you.
That's just how I feel.
Oh, you've got a stubborn streak in you. I think it comes from your father. Definitely not mine. He was always so determined, unable to admit to his mistakes.
What's your point, Mum?
My point is that nobody likes your father. Sorry. Just be careful, Cal.
Yeah. Thanks, Mum.
I'll let you go, darling. Ciao.
Casper.
Hey, you handled the Davidov situation really well today.
Yeah?
Yeah, making it about the big personalities rather than family issues. Saying it's no different for other teams, that was really smart.
Yeah, well, I mean, I've been answering the same question my whole life, so I guess I know how to spin it.
Maybe we should give you a job in PR.
I think I'll stick with driving the car for now.
Probably for the best. And well done for addressing the Davidoff stuff. I'm sorry you had to.
No, no big deal.
It is to me, Callie. So, thanks.
Scared the life out of me, mate.
Ah, didn't mean to. Picking up any tips?
I don't think they like the short strays here.
You didn't mind them, did you?
I love this track. Always do well here. Well, used to.
How are you doing, Dylan?
Me? Golden, mate. Loving life.
Sure.
You know what it's like to leave all this behind, don't you?
It's the most difficult thing I've ever done.
Yeah, well, like that. But, I didn't choose this, Casper. I didn't.
I know.
You came back, right? How's it treating you?
Ups and downs.
How's our old teammate doing?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't think he's happy here.
He still thinks he belongs in that top team, see? He's never let it go. That's the problem. You know, I could have a word with him. I mean, if you think that might help.
It's all a bit dead.
Uh-huh. Oh, I understand.
No, Devon, I mean it.
Yeah? Scout's on it, mate.
Hey, we need your input on this one.
Andreo.
Did you read his email?
I glanced at it.
He's a sly old fox at that one. Thank you for finding a place for Devon. As if we had a choice, Casper. As if it was our decision.
Yeah, I know.
How's it going with Devon anyway?
He's still struggling. But he does really care about the team, so, you know, maybe it'll work out.
Well, that's something at least.
Rather him than his father, right?
Rather neither of them, Casper. Anyway, I'll see you.
Yeah, see you.
Did Casper really want you to talk to Aiden?
I read between the lines. Look, Casper's good at lots of things, but I know people. Yeah, I know how to get in their heads. And I wanted to help Dad, help the team, so...
Leave me alone.
Listen, I'm just saying, mate, if you were such an incredible driver, you wouldn't be a Conisport, would you? Sorry, it's the truth. No offence.
Well, maybe I won't be here next season.
Oh, dude. You know what your problem is?
Yeah. You.
You think you're better than the team. I remember when Aiden Jackson was just happy to be behind the wheel of an F1 car. We all liked that guy far better than this one.
You never liked me.
No. But Casper did. Once upon a time. Oh, you're different now. You think you're too good for the team. Your head's stuck in some imaginary big three-seating cloud cuckoo land, mate. No. You have got to drive the car you're in.
You're lecturing me about ego.
A subject I know well.
Oh, right. I get it. So you're allowed to be cocky, but I'm not. Is that it?
There's a difference.
How can there possibly be a difference?
This isn't you. This isn't you, mate.
Oh, get lost. Be true to myself. Drive the car I'm in. The wisdom of Devon Butler. Should I be living my best life too?
Just drive the car you're in, mate, yeah? Ciao.
Bay hosted a Grand Prix that briefly ran in the 60s and 70s, but the Garden City re-entered the calendar for good in 2008. We missed it for a couple of years, but it was great to come back to the Singapore Grand Prix. The Marina Bay Street Circuit then has 23 corners, 13 to the left and 10 to the right, taking us a total of 3.1 miles around the landmarks of downtown Singapore. An average lap speed around here, just 107 miles per hour. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, just ahead of George Russell, who starts this event from P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Oscar Piastri, Perez, Fernando Alonso, Verstappen, Leclerc, Norris, Jackson, Joe, Ocon, Stroll, Mayer, De Vries, Magnussen, Tsunoda, Gasly, Bottas, Sargent, Hülkenberg, Sargent. That's it then, it's time to go racing. Well, it's a beautiful night here at the Marina Bay Circuit, and as ever, a really enthralling Singapore Grand Prix ahead of us.
That's right, Crofty, and while there's not many surprises at the top of the standings right now, there's a lot to watch out for further down the pack.
One driver I'll be definitely keeping my eye on is Conisport's Aiden Jackson. He's been less than consistent so far this season.
Aiden, you know what you're doing here. Let's lock in and give it everything. Show us what you got.
Nice work, mate. That brings you up a place. the pit window and you're going to be on medium. By 19.1 seconds.
fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Let's go. Okay, good work. Great pass. Callie's in the pits now. We'll be right back. Cab teammate by 42.7 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. They're in 15th. Time last lap was a 2 minutes 20.7. Okay, just 2 laps of fuel remaining now.
Some of the drivers out there today, Crofty, was nothing short of incredible.
Elbows out, especially from Aidan Jacks. Loved his race today, and he finally delivered the sort of performance that we know that he's capable of. So whatever they're saying to him over at Connersport, he seems to be listening to. Here comes your top three, making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One.
Now, Aidan, you have had your ups and downs this season, but tell me, on the whole, are you pleased with your overall performance?
Today's race should be a normality, not an exception. You know, if I can get a few more performances like today, then, yeah, I'll be much happier.
OK, I'm going to be cheeky, go straight for the jugular. If you had to choose a teammate between Callie and Devon, who would it be?
I'm getting into trouble whatever I say here, aren't I? Can I have Casper back as a teammate instead? I'll talk him out of retirement.
Now, Aidan, you have recently hinted that you're not entirely happy at Connersport. Tell me, is it true?
I think of Connersport in the same way I would my family. There are a lot of personalities to manage, but we're a tight-knit group in this team. We might not always see eye to eye, but in the end, we all want the same thing.
There's been wild speculation on whether or not Connersport can even be on the grid next season. So can you tell us more?
People were quick to judge the investors, but I think they care about this team and they want it to do well. I can't imagine anyone pulling out investment at this stage.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Hi, Davidoff.
Aiden, appreciate the support today.
Yeah, no worries.
You're right, the investors do care about this team. We all wanted to do well. Good to see you putting that message out there.
It's true though, isn't it? You're not gonna suddenly pull out of Konnersport, but the team's doing well.
It really doesn't matter, Aiden. Konnersport will get fifth and all this speculation will become irrelevant.
Well, what happens if we don't make fifth?
My position on that matter has always been clear. Thanks again, Aiden.
Check out.
Why? Because he told you to.
Stop making this about him. Just talk to me.
We raced in a lot of the same races growing up, and one of us would always have a better race than the other. So in the car on the way home, one of us would be happy and the other would be completely miserable. There was no middle ground. It was like it was impossible for us both to be happy at the same time. And it's kind of been the same ever since.
Look, it's my job to talk to the drivers, Callie.
Yeah, and who gave you that job?
Why are you being like this? It's not even me you're angry with.
Maybe it is.
Oh, really? This again? We were kids, Callie.
You left me behind.
Oh, come on, what was I supposed to say? Oh, thanks, Dad, for continuing to invest in my career, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to decline, just in case I hurt poor Callie's feelings.
Of course not.
And what?
It didn't have to be a choice, Dev. He had the money to fund both of our careers. I wanted you to fight for me. He never listened to me. He always listened to you.
Well, we were young.
Yeah. But we're adults now.
Yeah. Well, if it's any consolation, I'm not much competition anymore.
You never were.
I'm sorry, Kelly. For everything. You were always faster than me. There, I said it.
Nice try.
I mean it.
And did you mean it?
Of course not! Faster than me? No. She was never faster than me. She'd love that. Nah. But if there's one thing my old man taught me, it's that sometimes people need to hear what they need to hear. You know?
Hey, Mom.
Cal, I'm reading more and more about these funding issues.
Only an issue if we don't get fifth, apparently. What do you make of it all?
Well, he won't really do it, surely. I mean, it's only been two seasons, for goodness sake. And Connorsport certainly isn't the worst team on the grid.
You have a real way with words, Mum.
What's your father have to say for himself?
I have no idea.
You've still not spoken to him?
I'm sure you can relate.
Yes, but I mean, I don't have to work with the man. Look, you don't have to like him. You only have to talk to him.
You sound like Devon.
Oh, maybe Devon has a point.
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Mum. I'm going now.
Lots of love. Bye.
I saw him in the paddock. This would have been Sao Paulo. And I finally spoke to him. I just wanted to know why.
There's something's come up. I'll call you back. Callie, so I'm allowed to talk to you now.
Why are you doing this?
Doing what?
Why are you being so hard line about this?
For this to be a worthwhile investment, Connorsport Racing must be successful. It's just business.
It's not, though, is it?
Excuse me?
Well, why am I on the team if it's just business? Why was Devon? You can't keep involving your family in this and then hiding behind it's just business.
This is one of the biggest investments I have ever made. I must take care of the business. Come on. Who do you think will inherit it after I'm gone?
Well, Devon, obviously. I'm not interested in any of it.
Matters are complex, Callie. But they all benefit the business. They all benefit the family. And ultimately, they all benefit you.
You said this the last time you tried to stop me racing. I didn't buy it at 12, and I certainly don't buy it now. I don't understand what goes on in that head of yours. You threatened to end my F1 career, and then you claim it's for my benefit.
Have you any idea how much money I have plowed into the team?
Yeah, that's the thing with you. Money. Nothing changes.
I wouldn't expect you to understand.
No, Dad. I wouldn't expect you to.
You need to be more realistic, that's all. Not everyone survives in F1. You know that.
Fifth in the standings.
Fifth.
In this lap. Repeat, the safety car is in this lap. That means it's our chance to shine. Come on, you can do this. Let's go.
No pressure then.
Okay, clear.
need to give that place back. I'm afraid that was an illegal overtake. DRS is now online. By 11.9 seconds. Gap to your teammate behind is 11.9 seconds. They're on old mediums. They're in 10th place. And the time last lap was at 1 minute 23.5. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps. Let's go, final lap.
Fantastic race that was. Absolutely loved it. But Natalie, do you think we see Connorsport next season? Rumours say maybe not.
I hope so. I feel like they deserve it. They've been box office for me. They've taken chances. They've been bold in all their moves. And ultimately, that's great for us and for the fans.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more. But there's not much of the season left. And they'll be hoping they can carry this form into the final stages. Time will tell. A show-stopping performance from the three drivers approaching the podium right now. It's been an interesting Grand Prix, that's for sure.
Wow, Callie, a really strong performance out there today. Just tell me, though, how big a role did the safety car play?
Yeah, I mean, I really fancied my chances after the safety car. Obviously, it's gonna really disrupt the race, but I was able to take advantage of it today. I saw an opportunity and I went for it, and it worked out well.
Callie, your first F1 season is nearing an end. It must feel like a long road, but clearly you've put a lot into it. And is there anyone else that's been particularly influential this season?
I've got Casper to thank for so much of this. He was there for me in F2 last season, and he was the one who fought so hard for my seat at Connorsport. And without him, I may not even be here. So cheers to Casper.
And tell me, I'm not sure I could do it, but how has it been working so very closely with your family?
It's actually been all right. We don't always get on, but we know each other really well and we all know when to keep our distance. Or maybe we've learned when to keep our distance over the course of the season. Family's always complex, but yeah, it's been okay.
There are rumours circulating that Connorsport may not be around next season. can you comment?
I have reason to believe that those rumours are true, yeah? As far as I know, it's a decision that will be based on our results this season, so if we don't do well enough, you may not see us again.
Well, thank you for chatting with us. Great to have your time.
Okay, so we are running two quite different setups out there today. And you don't need me to tell you how it... You don't need me to tell you how it... Davidoff, that's enough!
I'm sorry?
Get out.
What on earth are you talking about?
I've had an entire season of you whispering in people's ears. I'm asking you to leave the meeting.
You can't be serious.
This is not your team. And after today, it might not even exist. So get out! And let those of us who actually care about the result do our jobs.
We'll talk about this later, Ackerman.
You can threaten me after the race.
So be it. You coming, Devon?
Yeah, I'm thinking I might actually stay. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna stay.
Well, that's up to you.
Okay, listen. You all know what's at stake. If we race as individuals today, the team dies. The only way we can survive this, the only way that any of us are coming back next season, is together. We all understand this? No. Aiden? Callie? Look at me. You look at me. We understand this, yes? If you put yourself ahead of the team today, it's no more team.
Callie. We got this.
Yeah.
And, I'm sorry if I was ever...
Wow.
What?
Are you apologizing?
Yeah.
I will forgive you on one condition.
What's that?
You get your share of the points.
All right. Deal.
Chin up.
Hey, did you find him?
I didn't look too hard, to be honest. Does Davidoff ever sulk?
Hard to imagine. Listen, I hope I haven't caused you problems. I snapped. It was unprofessional.
Not at all, Casper. It was a delight to watch.
You think it'll affect his decision?
I've given up speculating, Cass. At this stage, nothing would surprise me.
Yeah, well, we better get that result then.
I guess we better add. And good luck today, Casper. Whatever happens, I'm so grateful for all you've done.
Look, it's been my pleasure. Connor Sport deserves to succeed.
If the fates are kind, Casper. If the fates are kind. I'm trackside. I'll see you there.
Yeah, cool. I'll be a few minutes.
You know, before a race begins, anything is possible. Anything. On the one hand, you have the true icons of the sport, certain drivers, certain teams who set the pace, who you expect to do well. On the other hand, you have the underdogs. And we are always there, always pushing for another place, another point, looking for the smallest opportunity, the tiniest mistake we can punish. And in that moment, just before lights out, it's like the world holds its breath. You know? Everybody just waits. The air is heavy, you know? And I knew whatever happened, Corner Sport had made its mark on the history of the sport. And I was at peace with that.
So you weren't nervous?
Are you kidding?
So we know how it stands right now, but just how different might it be when the checkered flag waves here in Abu Dhabi? And it's lights out, and away we go!
Okay, Aidan, let's see if we can start moving through the field. It's time to push. Come on, you've got this. Gap ahead is 2.4 seconds. Main straight we go. Here goes Jackson again, moving up the field. What a great race for him.
Yeah, it really is so far, Prof. I mean, it's a circuit he really enjoys. Remember the race in 2021 that he put together there? It was fantastic stuff back then.
Who could forget it? Connor Sport need a performance just like that today. May is doing okay. Jackson really delivering.
Great stuff, Aidan. Come on, I think we can get one more place here. Push, push. Something's all right. Assessing. Stand by. I'm losing speed.
Heading down the back straight now. He's in a great spot, but hang on, he's slowing. Something is very, very wrong.
Yeah, I think he's got a problem here, Crofty. I wonder what it is. Could it be engine related?
Look, they're throwing their hands in the air on the pit wall, and he's out.
And yeah, that's the engine gone.
2023 is over for Aidan Jackson. It's a dramatic exit, and it wasn't what he was hoping for.
Something happened up there.
Yeah, engine failure, I'm afraid. Aidan is out of this race. Repeat, Aidan's out of the race. Did you get that?
Aidan's out. I heard.
What?
Let me speak for that.
Why?
Just give me the headset.
Sure about this?
I'm sure about everything.
That's what concerns me.
Kelly.
Devin?
Yeah, we've had a chat. We think it's best if you don't push the car too hard.
Why?
Look, you're way back, Cal, okay? We don't want to blow your engine too, so just cruise it in and finish the race.
It's got to be realistic here. Copy.
Sorry, is this a team order?
No, Casper agrees. It's just not going to make up that much ground. It can't be done. Just cruise it in, Cal. Trust me, you watch her go.
Running in third, P3.
just 5 laps of fuel remaining.
incredible performance by her today. Konnersport sure will be very delighted with that one.
And if you believe the rumours, Anne, this is a team whose future has been in doubt. Surely, though, they've done enough to return next season. I think they've been wonderful to watch.
Devon.
Not bad today, sis. Not bad at all.
You did that on purpose.
Did what on purpose?
Oh, come on, Dev. Cruise it in.
I don't know what you're talking about, mate. You went against the team order. It's poor form, that.
I can't believe I missed it at the time. It seems so obvious now.
Listen, you want to lay off the sauce, Cal. Seriously, it's a bit embarrassing. I mean...
I'm surprised Casper let you, to be honest. Really surprised.
Okay, I'm going now, because you're not making any sense. Okay? Ciao!
Yep. Ciao. Dad.
California.
That good enough for you?
Look, I thought we maybe could grab a coffee tomorrow before we head off. My flight's not till 3.
Yeah,
have a chat, talk about next season. It'd be good for us. Well, think about it anyway. The offer stands.
You make it sound like a negotiation.
It always is with us, Callie. You let me know.
It was amazing. I'm not sure I've ever seen a race like that. I was wrong about Callie.
And how did you feel about the engine failure?
There's no such thing as the perfect car. The one that failed us was the same one that got us here in the first place. So, you've just got to drive the car you're in.
Well, everyone's an individual. Which means that everyone is, motivated a little differently. Take Devon as an example. He always responds well to having his ego brushed, to being told that he's the best. His greatest fear is failure, so it gives him further to fall, keeps him hungry. Callie, on the other hand, has an innate drive to prove people wrong. If someone tells her something's not possible, she'll do everything in her power to achieve it. A sort of a stubborn determination that can be harnessed. And then there's Aiden. I mean, when he started in F1, people thought he was a nice guy, but he was incredibly ambitious. It's just what makes Aiden tick. Which is why I may have started a rumour or two about interest from other teams during his time at Konnersport. To stoke that ambition. Keep his eyes on the horizon.
A lot of people might see that as manipulative, wouldn't you agree?
Well, of course. Motivation is manipulation. It's the same thing.
Is it?
Look, the end justifies the means. After all, it's just business.
Looking forward to next season?
Just let me at it.
Will you stay next season?
I've told Casper I'll stay if he does.
Do you still have a job after your run-in with Davidoff?
Well, we'll see.
We did it! We secured the funding! What a team!
And that's all that matters.
Right now, yes, that's all that matters.
Okay, so we done? Yeah? Cool. Ciao.
Let's focus now for the rest of the race. Well, we didn't hit the target today, so there's definitely room for improvement there, but you did bring it home cleanly, so I'll take that.